Good morning, children. I am Mrs. Priya Ravi. I am going to take class for matric students 9th standard geography first lesson. That is lithosphere, endogenetic process. Do you all know Earth is like a sphere? Yes, it's like a ball, round shape, everything you have learned in the earlier classes. Now we are going to learn about the Earth and the lithosphere. Okay, now we are going to know. The Earth is a unique planet in the solar system, and it is also called as a blue planet. And another one for the Earth is our home planet also. Do you all remember that? Yes. The Earth is composed of four spheres, namely the lithosphere, the atmosphere, the hydrosphere, and the biosphere. This lesson is really on the internal process of the Earth. Okay, now we are going to learn about the spheres of the Earth system. Shall we move to the class? Everybody will be having a question, that is, how Earth is made up of and what all is there? I mean, not the top layer, interior layer and all. Now we are going to know about Earth is made up of what and what is on the Earth's surface. Okay, the Earth can physically be described as a ball. It is like a round ball of rock and covered by the water, hydrosphere. The rock ball is called lithosphere and the water part is called a hydrosphere, and the wrapped in the envelope of air is called as the atmosphere. Have you all know, children? Now these three physical zones, it's convenient to add a biological zone, that is called as biosphere. Okay, children, shall we move? Now we are going to start about the spheres of the Earth. Earth's surface is the very vast area of 510 million square kilometers. Have you all known how it is? Yes. It is a 510 million square kilometer. Where four spheres of the Earth is interacted. The abiotic spheres are the lithosphere, atmosphere and hydrosphere. The biotic sphere is the biosphere. Together, these spheres constitute the planet Earth. These all form and made the Earth. This topic, lithosphere, has been taken and convinced is divided into endogenetic process, internal process that is, and exogenetic process, that is external process. Internal process and external process are there. These are two types. This is lesson fully about the, that is, What about? That is internal process. Shall we move? See this picture all well. Have you all able to see? Yes. See, it is mentioned as the round, that is round shape in the middle. It is biosphere and topmost is called atmosphere, and second fold is called hydrosphere, and third is called lithosphere, the full Earth, spheres of the Earth. Okay, children, have you understood? Now, the lithosphere is the solid outer part of the Earth. The atmosphere is the thinner layer of gases surrounded the Earth. The hydrosphere is the watery part of the Earth's surface, including ocean, rivers, lakes and water vapor. The biosphere is the layer of the Earth where life existed, where the all human beings and the all animals are the, what all the life has, it is on the Earth life. That is called as biosphere. Okay, children. Now, we are going to know the structure of the Earth. See the interior structure of the Earth. If you cut an apple, we can see the, we can take as the apple, you cut and see how it is. When outside we are seeing, we are not able to see anything. Interior, we can make out the same way we take an onion, and when we cut, it has lot of layers. Yes, first is thinner layer and second is little thicker, or like that. So there is lot of layers. Same way in the structure of the Earth also, there is lot of layers. That is called the outer surface and the inner core of the Earth are totally different in their nature. Yes, outside of the Earth and interior of the Earth is mostly differ, because outside we can see only the, see the mountains, plateaus, plains, forests and water, that all. But inside, have you able to see that? No, it is something different. So the structure of the Earth's interiors is divided into three layers. That is called the crust, the mantle and the core. Have you seen this figure? See this figure. How it is? All the layers are there. Okay, children. Next, we are going to the crust. Crust is the outer layer of the Earth. The crust is the outer layer of the Earth where we live. See, the Earth is having the skin. That is what? It is the skin of our Earth is what? Soil. Yes? Which ranges between 5 to 30 kilometers. It is the solid and rich layer of the Earth. The thickness of the crust is greater below the contents than the ocean floor, continents and all. Okay. The crust is classified into mantle. See, we are going to know about the different things. That is continental crust, oceanic crust. Okay, there is two types, that is continental crust and the oceanic crust. The major elements of the crust is called silica. That is silica and aluminium together, it is called as sea. Silica and aluminium together, it called as sea. Okay. And the continental crust and the oceanic crust. Have you seen this figure? Yes. See, continental crust. That is brown color. Continental crust, oceanic crust and upper mantle. Now, the lithosphere and the crust are not the same. The lithosphere is the crust and uppermost part of the mantle. And the planets have lithosphere. The lithosphere of Mercury, Venus and Mars much thicker than the Earth. Now we are going to learn about the mantle. That crust is contained of silica and what? Aluminium. It is called shell. And now mantle, that is consist of silica and magnesium. It is called sima. The inner part of the crust is called mantle. Okay, children. Now this what happened in the upper part of the mantle, the rock remains solid. But the lower part of the mantle, rocks are in molten form. That is, when it is boiled and because of the heat and pressure, this become a magma. The earth inside the rock will be melted and become a magma. Do you know magma? Yes. Magma is a red fiery liquid. Core. The core is the innermost and hottest layer of the earth, which lies below the mantle. Okay, the core is the innermost but very hottest in the earth, which lies below the mantle. And the nickel, mainly it is of nickel and iron. And solid inner core is the liquid outer core. This is presence of the large quantity iron in the core and responsible for the earth's gravitational force. Do you know earth is having gravitational force? Because of the gravitational force only we all are able to stand. Otherwise there is no gravitational force. What will happen? Everything will fall down. Because of that only, when we throw something up, it will come down to the floor by the pull of the gravitational force. As the earth rotates on its axis, the liquid outer core spins over the solid inner core and generates the earth's magnetic field. Okay, this is responsible for the functioning. Now, we are going to know the deepest place ever reached by the human and technology was till 2011, Kola Super Hole is 12,262 meters in Russia was deepest place, but it is broken the record by the 12,376 meter. Nobody can find the innermost of the part. Now we are going to know about the rocks. Everybody knows what is rocks. There are different size of rocks, different color, and it is have different size and weight. Everything will be different. The rock will not be in same size or same color. The crust is the storehouse of rocks and of minerals on the earth's crust is called a rock. It may be very hard and compact like granitic or soft as clay and loose as sand. There are three magnification, that is granite, soft clay or sand. Now types of rocks. Do you know what all types of rocks are there? Yes, igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks and metachromic rocks. Very good. Fact. You can be able to see some caves in the rock cut architecture in India, like Ajanta and Ellora caves in Maharashtra and Batmini and in Karnataka and Konark temple in Odisha and Mamallapuram in Tamil Nadu. These are some important rock cut temples carved in the rock. See, date of the earth's interior is given. The layers, the thickness, the top density, bottom density, types of the rock found during the upper, that is crust, upper mantle, lower mantle and outer core and all. This is all mentioned here. You can notice, able to read this? Yes. Okay children, now we'll go to igneous rock. the three types of rocks already we came to know. First we are going to know about the igneous rock. The word igneous is derived from the Latin word ignis, meaning fire. The interior earth contains very hot molten material called magma. When magma reaches the earth's surface, it is referred to as a lava. Yes, when a volcano bursts, we'll say lava is coming out of the volcano. It is magma, red fire, liquid. It like you can see the crackers. In Tamil, say buswano. How it will be? When it bursts, it flow through outside. It is like that. It is coming. Okay. Next, we are going to sedimentary rocks. There is sedimentary rocks are named after the Latin word sediment, meaning settled rivers, glaciers, and winds carry bits of the rock, soil, and deposit on them in a layers. These are the types they given. That is types of rocks. And examples, use granite and all. And what are the types and what are examples and for what they using. Okay. Now you can see this. After few million years, this deposit harden into compact rock and are called sedimentary rocks. The small broken rocks are carried out. After a million years, it is deposit on the compact rock or called sedimentary rocks. And these contain some bodies of the plants, animals that fall on the deposit gate, and it is mixed in the layers and form fossils. Sandstone, limestone and chalk, gypsum, coal and sedimentary rocks are combined of this all. And metabromic rocks. What is metabromic rocks? The term metabromic. Metabromic is derived from the word which means change of form. When igneous or sedimentary rocks are subjected to extreme heat and pressure, they undergo a complete change in their form and character. So granite may be transferred to basalt, gneiss too, and limestone, marble and sandstone. Okay children, see, lot of types of rocks are there. You are able to see? Yes. So I am going to complete this chapter till this. And in the next class, I'll continue this lesson. Till that, you listen to this audio and watch the video properly. And I will ask you a simple question from this lesson. You must answer. Okay, children, have a nice day. Bye-bye.